Salutations, friends. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be kind of like, not a vlog, but a talking video where I talk about my passion project that I've mentioned in the past that I was going to be sharing with you guys the entire process of once I got to a specific point. If you guys are wondering or if you guys are unfamiliar, I'm actually working on developing a fragrance or a few fragrances. So I'm going to share what I've done up to this point and what I'm planning on doing in the future, and also just explaining a little bit more of this project and the process. So if you guys want to know a little bit more, then keep watching. First off, do understand I don't have any illusions of grandeur. I don't think this is going to be anything humongous. I don't think it's going to be huge, and I'm not expecting to be like imaginary authors or zoologist perfumes. I don't even expect to be anything big on Etsy, which is probably going to be the primarily place I'm selling this. This is more just a passion project because there's a few fragrances I've just had in my head that I've really wanted to experience, and I thought the best way to experience them would be to create them myself. And so I do have a bit of experience starting my own business, managing my own business, especially from the ground up, from scratch, which is one of the reasons why I wanted to do this video series with you guys, was because I wanted to share with you guys how to start your own business financially, how to market and things like that. And I was going to be using this project as the kind of like the gateway to share with you guys my experiences. So the first important thing to realize is this is going to be kind of a talking, more of a resource video. So if you like my more review videos or like my chit-chat catch-up videos, this is not going to be the video for you. But if you guys are interested in the process of starting your own business, running your own business, like marketing, creating products, and all the nitty-gritty that goes behind that, this might be a video series for you guys. So this is going to be the first one, and I wanted to start off from when I had the basic idea down, almost like a prototype. Because when you start a business, you need to have an idea of what you want, and then you go from there. Then you look for sources, then you figure out how you're going to make the product, then you're going to figure out legalese and things like that. So for me, I wanted a fragrance prototype before I just started running at you guys with different places to buy your stuff, and this is what you have to do to set up your business, and this is the taxes, and good lord, afford an accountant, because there's no way you're going to be able to do your taxes in the beginning, and accountants are worth their weight in gold. So this video is going to be more coming up to the point. It's going to be telling you guys what I worked up to get to this point, and then the next step. So this is going to be like the step one of starting your own business, which is developing a product. Turn the AC because it's so hot. So let me introduce to you the product. The name on the bottle is not the name of the company, and it's not the name of the fragrance. This was initially what I was going to do. And the place where I get stickers and stuff, they had like a buy one, get one free. So I bought a bunch of stickers and just slapped something on there. Initially, this is what the company was going to be called, which is going to be the Wayward Flower Perfumes and Other Lovelies. But it's going to be more androgynous. It's not going to be so whimsical and cute, although I have nothing against whimsical and cute. So I had so many of these stickers lying around, I've been using them for prototypes. So this is the first official prototype of the fragrance that I want to develop. What I'm going to be doing is, this has been in the works for a year, guys. This is what I'm going to be doing is I want to really work and create the best fragrances I can create. And that requires, for me, constant fidgeting and working with the formula and figuring out the best place to get the best ingredients. I'm trying to make this affordable because I don't want it to be very expensive, but I also want to use the best ingredients I can afford. So for me, it's about getting out the best product as possible. To get the prototype down, though, I didn't have the money to just slap together and throw together, not throw obviously, some of the ingredients that were expensive. I wanted to wait until I had an idea of the body or the DNA that I want of the fragrance, and then I'm going to work around with maybe fidgeting with a few things, removing a few notes, adding more of this, less of this. So the basic DNA of this fragrance is, I'm working on it, the idea of this is going to be a very universally unisex fragrance that's more on the feminine side of unisex than the masculine side of unisex. And I really love how those fragrances play, and I also love how those fragrances wear on men. I think they're very sexy. So the idea behind this fragrance is I will tell you the base notes I have right now. Now these will obviously change, but in this juice, they are all in equal proportions, and that's ultimately what I decided to do. I've made this juice probably about 40 times. I've gone through so many different essential oils and trying different carrier oils and different varieties of specific fragrances, like different woods, different opening notes, and I've kind of come down to this is the basic DNA that I like for this fragrance. So these aren't top notes, base notes, middle notes. These are just general, the notes that I have right now. These will be changed and tweaked, but this is kind of the foundation that I like for this fragrance. So we have vanilla, orange, jasmine, rose, tobacco, brown sugar, leather, patchouli, and sandalwood. Overall, this is actually a really nice fragrance just like this. Speaking from experience, it's a very leathery, deep, kind of smoky-esque orange citrus fragrance, which I think is really, really nice. And I really like playing and balancing between, and I'm not saying that this is how it is, but you ever have like a meal that's both salty and sweet, or like spicy and sour, and it's just this beautiful balance? That's what I'm trying to create with this fragrance. I'm really trying to find the perfect balance for this. So this is the DNA that I like. I like the warmth of the sugar, the leather, the tobacco, and the vanilla mixed with the brightness of the citrus, and the patchouli anchors everything, and then the jasmine and the rose kind of give it a really nice, just a floral aspect, which is what I'm looking for, to make it a little bit on the more feminine side of unisex than the masculine. But at the same time, I'm trying to have it have a beefiness to it. So far, this smells, again, really nice. The top notes that I get out of this mostly is I get a lot of orange, a lot of brightness, but it's also very creamy, and you get a lot of leather and sandalwood in this, which is really, really nice. The issue that I have with this fragrance is the fact that it doesn't last as long on the skin as I'd like, but again, I completely think that's the ingredients, or the quality of the ingredients. Again, this is just a prototype. This is nothing that I would ever sell. This is something that I'm just playing with and messing with. I'm going to wear probably through, I'm going to try and wear through this for a few months actually, to see exactly how I want to do it, which is what I did creating this. Is I would wear it for like 3 or 4 weeks, and then I would write notes and say, I want this, I want more of this, and that's kind of like how I got to this. So that's what I need to do with this. So I get a lot of the orange, I get a lot of the leather. It's like a creamy, but it's a little too creamy, you know, it's a little bit too almost cream soda. So what I need to do is I need to dial back a little bit on the vanilla, and I'm thinking about switching the brown sugar to sugar cane and also adding maybe some bite to it. So I'm thinking of maybe a musk, I don't know. But that's ultimately where I am with this project, and I'm really excited so far. But I guess to bring this back to starting your own business, it's going to be developing a product. You really want to have a clear vision in your head when it comes down to what you want to create before you move forward with a lot of the crazy financials and big decisions that you would have to make. So for me, it was about getting specific fragrance oils and figuring out sources to buy the nice fragrance oils once I was ready to move forward past the prototype stage, which is where I'm at right now. This is the first batch of prototype. I just finished it last night after, again, months and months of sampling the other versions, and I'm ready to finally move forward with the next step. If you are doing a business, say you are starting a skincare line, say you are starting candles, soap, even if you're selling art, you want to have a clear idea in your head of what you want to do business-wise. With all of my businesses, all of my art businesses, glassware businesses, and even my side businesses such as my curiosity shop that's in the works and the jewelry shop, You want to have a clear plan of attack. I have a 1 year, a 5 year, and a 10 year plan with all of our businesses. And you know, you might not make all of your goals, but I feel it's very good to have little goals in between. For an example of my glassware business, which is where a primary bulk of my income comes from, we started off with the basic equipment, the cheapest that we could get, until we figured out what was financially viable for us to get in the future. Some people will say don't do that, but I find that it's best not to get into debt with a business right off the bat until you know if it's financially worth the investment. Here's an example. When we started our business, or the glassware business, to get all the equipment that we needed just to run and create a high quality product without the crazy top of the line equipment, it cost us about $2,500. About 4 years ago, we upgraded to all top of the line equipment, and I mean top of the line equipment. We spent about $60,000 on that stuff. And there's still a few other pieces of equipment that we need to get, which will probably be $20,000 to $30,000. But we let the $2,500 equipment purchase take us and make us enough money to where when we bought the $60,000, we bought that with cash and not on credit. We bought it straight out because we didn't have a crazy investment in the beginning. And if our business hadn't taken off the way that it did, or maybe it wasn't as viable as it was, we would have only had a $2,500 loss rather than a $60,000 to $70,000 loss. So in the long run, it actually made more sense for us to get by with what we had and suffer through until we were ready to make the initial investment into our business, which I'm telling you, currently right now, we have about $100,000 worth of equipment for our glassware business. If you guys check out our glassware online, I will link the places below. We use top of the line equipment and top of the line techniques to create the most perfectly etched glassware you can come at. We can do just about anything. There's a lot of other people that get more detail, but they use other techniques. We love the sandblasted technique. I think it gives you the most luxurious, beautifully well-etched glasses that don't look cheap. They look like they're made with a lot of money. And we use the best glasses. I mean, we really put a lot of effort and time in creating the best products we possibly can, and it shows in our product, and I'm very proud of our finished product, and I'm also very proud of that business. So I'm using that same mentality, and I wanted to kind of talk about that when I'm talking about this, so that you know where I'm coming from when I say this is my business. I'm not running a little Etsy shop side business, and there's nothing wrong with that. This is a viable business where my husband and I make our income. You see all the stuff I buy on here? You guys ask where my money comes from our own business. So do understand that my advice is coming to you as a business owner who runs a successful business from home. So I'm using that same mentality when it comes down to this project. And I want you guys to understand the full meaning of that when I talk to you guys about this project. That doesn't mean that
all of my advice is going to be perfect.
That doesn't mean that all of my advice is going to work in every situation. I'm going to try and keep this as nebulous as possible. But I did kind of want to let you know that that's the mentality of running every single one of my businesses. That's where my husband and I come from when we run our businesses. And with the amount of success that we've had doing that, that's where I'm coming at with this fragrance business. So that's why I wanted you guys to understand what I'm talking about. Please don't make the initial investment. Don't go crazy. It's coming from a place of we didn't, and it makes a lot more sense to not get in crazy debt until you know if it's worth the investment. So for me with the fragrance is I made small investments. I didn't buy the nicest ingredients. I didn't buy the best carrier oil or the top of the line stuff. I got a lot of the basic, really inexpensive essential oils and fragrance oils to develop a DNA. And now that I've developed the DNA and I didn't spend a lot of money wasting it on ingredients that don't deserve to be wasted, they deserve to be praised and used in a manner that they will be appreciated, I am ready now to make the bigger investment into a lot of higher end and top of the line ingredients to really refine this DNA. But the first thing that I need to do is figure out how to tweak it or genetically modify or however you want to say it. So my thoughts right now are, is I love the feel of this fragrance. I love the DNA and the bulk of it, but it needs balance and it needs a little bit of refinement and tweaking. So again, I'm probably going to switch up the brown sugar to maybe a sugar cane. I might add a boost-like element to this. It needs a little bit of brightness and balance, a little bit more acidity. It sounds like I'm cooking, but I'm not. And it needs to be a little bit more bitter to balance out the creamy sweetness. So that's what I'm going to be working on the next few months. But I did want to talk to you guys about the first half of the first part of the fragrance journey and creating this business, but also give you guys a little bit of small business advice, because that's part of what the series is, and that's what some of you guys have asked for. The most important thing about running your own business or creating a product or anything is to always have the product and your integrity intact. That is one of the most important things. Don't compromise anything that you don't have to, because it'll bite you in the butt in the future. So important to keep your integrity when it comes down to your product, when it comes down to your business practices, when it comes down to everything, because ultimately that's what you're going to be falling back on time and time and time again. You want to be able to stand behind anything that you do, any choices that you make, because a lot of times when you're starting your own business, especially if you're looking at it to be a primary source of income, people are going to second guess you all the time. I can't tell you how many times family members and friends were like, when are you guys getting a real job? Why are you guys doing this? You're not making any money. Go out and get a job. And we're like, we make more money than we did when we worked actual jobs. But people don't see it like that because they view this as being like a craft or hobby, when it is a hobby, but a lot of times you can make real or even better money doing this, but you have to put the work into it. You have to put the time into it, and you have to make very smart decisions. So the first thing, again, is to have a clear idea of your product in mind. Have a good plan set in place. Like, I would say do a 1, 5, and 10 year. Don't expect to make a lot of money in the beginning, so don't make crazy investments unless you absolutely have to. If you don't get top of the line equipment and it means you have to work a little bit harder for the first few years, depending on the price difference or the cost difference, make the work a little bit harder. I promise you, a lot of people say invest because your time is valuable. Your time is valuable, and if it makes more sense for you to invest a little bit more because the time difference is going to be crazy, then absolutely yes. But don't just buy into, I need to buy the best to set up my business, because you're going to put yourself, if you make that decision with everything, you're going to get yourself into debt, you're going to get discouraged, you're not going to make a lot of profit in the beginning, and you don't know if your product's going to sell. It doesn't mean that it's not a good product, but people still... Some people will ignore really good products and buy crap products, or vice versa. So you really want to make sure that you are making the correct decisions in the very beginning. You want to be very smart. You want to be very mindful of time and money. And definitely don't be afraid to get your hands dirty when it comes down to work. So ending this here after I've recorded this like 3 times, it hasn't recorded. Oh my goodness. I'm going to recap. When it comes to your business, using this as an example, give yourself a financial crutch. You don't want to be crazy in debt. You don't want to make a crazy investment until you know that you will gain your money back plus some. So always make very mindful, smart decisions in the beginning. It's easy to want the nicest, prettiest, sparkliest, best equipment in the beginning. And even if you have the money for it, until you know your product is going to sell, make smart decisions. I'm not saying go out and buy the cheapest thing. Don't buy something that is poor quality because, you know, it's the cheapest thing out there. Make smart, smart decisions, because in the beginning, it's all going to eat itself. You're going to be putting so much more money into your business, you don't even realize. It doesn't matter what you're doing. It's just going to be that's just the case of everything. You're not really going to start making a profit until the first few years. So you really have to make smart decisions. You don't want to be crazy in debt because you had to get the biggest, shiniest thing. But once you start making a profit, then you can really start seeing what equipment you would need or what supplies you would need. It also gives you experience to know what is fluff and what is hype and what is worth the money. So that's also really good too. You want to have that experience. Again, using this as an example, I use the cheapest ingredients. If I had started off with using the quality of ingredients that I'm ultimately going to use, I would have probably spent $2,000 or $3,000 for the and that's, it might sound crazy because that is an insane amount, but I promise you, I've gone through dozens and dozens of different ingredients and different juices and different carrier oils and different packaging, everything, you guys. It all adds up. You think $2,000 or $3,000, no way. But if you think about it, if I make an order every month or two for $100 to try new things, to test things out, and the things that don't work I don't use, that's kind of like what I'm saying. Like, and then you have stuff sitting around, and then you have this crazy investment, and you're like, I don't like this. So I spent a few $100, got the DNA down, and now I am ready to move forward and get a lot nicer ingredients, higher quality ingredients, and also wear this for a few months, because that's usually what I do, is I wear this for 2 to 3 months, and really tweak and take notes and figure out how I want to tweak the fragrance. So yeah, that's where I'm at. Again, I'm gonna end this video now because, again, I keep recording over it or not pressing the record button. I hope you guys like this video, and I hope you guys are excited for this video series. I'm really excited to bring this to you guys. I've been meaning to bring it to you guys for a while, but I wanted to wait until I at least had the DNA and the basic bulk of the fragrance down. Because I figured if I'm just constantly talking about, I mixed these together and it was rancid and I threw it away, or I mixed this together and it was way too sweet and I threw it away, this is way too bitter, I wanted to wait until I had a kind of a tangible thing I could show you and be like, oh, this is what I'm moving forward with. That's where I wanted to wait with this video. Again, I don't want you to think that I'm saying that my advice is perfect, because it's not. But I do want you guys to understand that the money that I spend on fragrances, a lot of you guys are like, where do you get that money? Or, oh my gosh, that's so expensive. It's from my home business. It's from my home business. This is where we get our money. This is how we make our money. This is how we make our living. So I want you guys to understand that I'm coming at you with experience. I would never tell you to just take my word for it with anything, especially when it comes to home business or your livelihood. Definitely go out there and research, read, talk to people who do it. Spend as much time as possible finding the best way to take this approach, especially if you're looking at this to be your primary source of income. But I hope that this was at least a resource for you guys, and I hope I at least gave you a little bit of knowledge. I don't know. We'll see. Also, if you guys have any questions on anything that I've talked about, feel free to let me know in the comment section below. I will be more than happy to answer any questions you have. And if any of the questions you have are going to be in a future video, I will still answer them, so you don't have to wait until the next segment of this video, which will probably be in the next few months, because again, I want to do this at a more real pace and not rush it. So the next video, I'm just letting you know what it'll probably be, which will probably be about right now, will be sourcing your materials. It doesn't matter what you're creating, at some point you need to get materials. If you're creating candles or soaps, you need materials. If you're creating fragrance or skincare, you need materials. If you're an artist, you still need materials. Pretty much no matter what you do, unless you're working in the digital realm, you need real materials. So I'm going to talk to you about sourcing things, tips and tricks to save money, and also just a little bit more on the accounting end of it as well, like what you can take off for taxes and how you can make smart business purchases as well. So that's going to be the next video, but if you guys have any questions about that now, feel free to let me know below. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, remember to give it a thumbs up. It lets me know to continue doing videos like this, and also don't forget to subscribe, because it's free and I'm free. I put out new videos every Monday through Friday, and sometimes on the weekends as well, so I'll always have something for you to watch. In any case, I hope you guys are all happy and healthy and have a great day, month, year, whatever, and I'll see you next time. Bye!